Hi, this is Margaret with Walnut Creek CERT, call sign Alpha Juliet 6 Lima Papa. I am creating a little video on how you can store a Simplex frequency in your Wouxon UV3D or equivalent handheld radio. I'm going to take you through it step by step, and I'm also going to attach in the link the documents that I'm going to refer to today. I want to caution you that some of this will go fast, but the purpose of putting it in a video is that you can then stop the video, rewatch it, etc. And I'm always available to help you do it in real life time, so whatever helps you. We are going to focus on programming the frequency, the Simplex frequency 145680 into the radio, as this video is intended for those people who have volunteered to conduct the Zero Thursday Night 1900 Hour Net. It's the Central County Net that takes place on frequency 145.680. So let me make a little change here. Okay. The first thing we want you to do is to make sure you're starting with a fully charged radio. You're gonna turn it on.
Channel mode 16.
And you see that there is the locked icon. You're gonna unlock the radio by holding down the lock key. You see that my radio shows the preset channel 16, which is the Walnut Creek repeater. Let me illuminate that again. And so the first thing you're going to want to do is make sure that you're operating. Let's operate on the top line of these two lines. So on your radio, if you hit A or B, the A or B key, you'll see it moves the arrow down to the upper or lower frequency. Let's play on the upper frequency right now. Doesn't matter where, what frequency you have in, but for the purposes of this training, you're going to start when you're in name mode, and I'll explain that, but you should be able to see the name of a channel. So this is Walnut Creek Repeater and channel 16. First thing we're going to do before we start programming anything is to try and identify an empty memory channel. For those of you who have, who got their Wouxon radio through Walnut Creek CERT, and where their radio was pre-programmed to the Walnut Creek standard ham band. I'm gonna show you the ham band and I'll send this to you, but the ham band changed, the programming changed a little bit over the years. So depending upon when your radio was programmed, you will likely have something like this that shows all of the channels that are in your radio, and you're gonna see that around 97, channel number 97, you don't have anything properly programmed for channel number 98, and then you probably have something programmed for 99. You might not have anything programmed for 100, so, and then you probably don't have anything programmed after 129. We're gonna identify first the empty memory channel. And an easy way to do that is to hit the scan button, and when you and watch as the channels roll by, and if nothing is on channel 98, you'll see the counter go from 97 to 99. Now another way to do that is while you are in this name mode, if you type in 098, it didn't go anywhere. It stayed on the Walnut Creek repeater because there's nothing programmed in 98 on my handheld radio. I am putting down, whenever I go to program my radio, I always write out all of the steps in detail. This is a really good way to do this. It was taught to me by a more experienced ham, and I do it every time. It just helps me not to miss steps. These radios are a little unforgiving. They want you to move fast in the programming. So it's just really important that you write everything down. I have identified that channel number 98 is a vacant channel. And when you find, another thing is when you find a vacant channel, you try to go into that channel, you're going to hear three quick tones to let you know that that's not a valid channel. So I'm going to do that again so you can hear the tone.
0, 9.
Do, do, do. Okay, so that's my empty channel. So I'm putting in, that's the channel I'm going to attempt to program with the Central County net frequency, which is 145.680. Okay. The first thing that we're going to do after we've unlocked the radio and we've made sure that we're on the upper frequency is that we are going to put the radio in frequency mode. And what you do to get the radio in a different mode, and the two I only use are frequency and name, is that you hit the red menu button, you type in 2-1, and you hit menu again to secure that you're in that menu, and then you will rotate the knob to the word frequency, and you're going to hit menu again. Now you're in the frequency menu. So let me show you that. Again, it's unlocked. I'm going to hit
function select
2-1 menu. Now I'm in frequency mode. I'm going to rotate. Sorry, it moves really quickly. So
menu. Function select
2-1 menu. Now you'll see it says it's in name mode. I'm going to rotate the dial till I see the word frequency, and I'm going to hit menu.
Frequency mode.
So now I'm in frequency mode, and how I know I'm in frequency mode is that when I turn the dial, I can see frequencies on that top line. What I'm going to do is I'm going to dial to 145.680, which is our desired Central County Net Simplex channel. And now that we're on, I could use the radio like this. I could lock it and use it, but you're going to want to store this. So let's go through the steps to store 145.680 into the memory, and let's name it so you can identify it in future. In order to store this frequency, so we're in frequency mode, we've got the frequency listed, you're going to go into the memory mode. So you're going to menu, 2-7 menu.
Channel, memory.
Okay. Now, you see it says we're in, see it's fast, menu.
Function select.
2-7 menu.
Channel,
okay.
Memory.
So it's currently on memory channel 16. I'm going to rotate that until I get to '98, because that's the place we decided we're going to store this. It was an empty channel. It just takes a minute. I'm sure there's a faster way to do this. All your Elmers out there know how to do it faster. So I go to number 98 and I hit menu.
Memory.
Okay. So what that means is that 145.680 is currently stored in this radio at the position channel number 98. Now what we want to do is to name that so I can find it in future. All right. So we have created channel number 98, which is the 145.680 frequency. Now we're going to name that channel 98. The first thing we need to do is to enter name mode. We're currently on frequency mode. As you can see, we can see the frequency, but now we want to enter name mode. So we're going to do menu, 2-1 menu. Then you see we're on frequency, so we're going to move it until it says name, and we're going to hit menu.
Channel mode 98.
Okay. Now it shows the channel that we want to rename, so we're going to hit menu. 2-6 menu. And you'll see there's this flashing bar, so you're going to use your up arrow to put in, and I've decided to name this CCTYN, which is Contra Costa County Net, Central Net. You can name it whatever you want to name it, but they only give you 5 characters. To do that, we're going to go menu,
select.
2, 6, menu, which is what I just did. Then you use the up arrow, A, B, C, and then the down arrow to go to the next slot. And I'm going to hit another C. It'll go through the full alphabet. You can't use the down arrow to expedite your way back to the front of the alphabet. You have to go through all the letters and all the numbers. There's another C. Then the down arrow to get to the next slot. T, another down arrow. And then I'm going to use a Y, down arrow, and then I'm going to cycle through the alpha numeric to get to an N for net. And the next one, let's just say I'm going to use the number 1. Zero, 1. Okay, when you're done, you hit menu.
Enter.
Okay. Now you have named a channel 98. From now on, if you, let's go back to where I started, which is at the Walnut Creek repeater, preset channel 16. If I dial in 016, it's going to go to the repeater. If I dial 098, it goes to that channel that we just programmed. Good luck with that. And don't forget, you have your handy dandy quick reference card and instruction manual. These things can be found online if you no longer have them. All right, have fun. Thank you.